immediately I'm starting with a question, so people that are not here can come back, and people who are here just show that they are here. I'm starting with the main physical idea in Jetscape, probably, is separation of hard and soft physics. And I just want to make sure that you know what hard and soft physics means. So press yes, no, and right now, starting from this moment, take 60 seconds to think of it and type it and then post it in the chat after 60 seconds so you don't interfere with each other. So now 60 seconds countdown is going.
We are seeing yeses and noes tick up, and the what we're seeing is that about 2-1 are saying yes to no.
Which means it's a good question. Then it's a really good question. Because when I was a student, and once I was just at the lecture and somebody was talking about hard and soft, and I thought, is it like hardware and software? Is it like theoretical physics and experimental physics, hard physics and soft physics? And then I realized it's completely different terms. So. Okay, we have another 20 seconds, and in 20 seconds, we just post the answers.
I think someone may have reset the poll because now we're seeing 4-4. So I see fewer total responses. So just make sure that you have click yes or no again if you already did it, please.
Okay, so I don't see the chat. The chat is overviewed by the teaching assistants. So I don't know exactly what you are posting in the chat, but I hope that it is.
We haven't seen a lot of comments on either the Zoom or the Slack. So
okay, so right now you can actually post. 60 seconds are gone. Now you don't interfere with each other. Now press your enter.
By far, the winning answer is hasn't answered yes. Yeah, hasn't answered yet.
Okay. Well, Christian, let me know when I should continue because it seems to be taking longer than I expected.
Yeah, so we're seeing a lot of, I think the most people have not answered the poll, the yes or no question yet. We're starting to see more responses in words on the Slack chat and a handful on Zoom. But let me say, I think
Christine, I lost you.
I lost you too.
So to summarize, there are some responses on Zoom. Hi PT, hard QCDs, low PT, soft low PT particles emerging from hydrodynamics or other processes, hard physics mostly from initial hard scattering.
That's a decent answer. I think let's just go on with it. I think it was just important for me to know that you understand what's going on. So yeah, that's my next point. So high momentum particles, and this momentum cut is, well, you said that it's not very clear where it is exactly, but let's say above 10 GeV, it's definitely hard physics. Below 3 GeV, it's definitely soft physics. Somewhere in between is a complicated region. So when we are talking about hard physics, it's high momentum or jets, and about soft physics, it's low momentum or bulk. That's what the next point is showing. Hard physics is perturbative QCD and jets, and soft physics is statistical models and hydrodynamics and low PT physics. Now, there is some nice picture how to think about this. You can either imagine a fountain of water, and that would be a jet, and this fountain of water is shooting through the dense fog, that will be bulk. Or if you are more into stronger interaction, then you can imagine jet in jacuzzi. Then a jet of water will be going through the jacuzzi and the water in jacuzzi will be the bulk. So this will be the picture for jets in the fog. And then jets of water will correspond to harder physics and fog will correspond to softer physics, or you can think about water jets in jacuzzi. And in both cases, it makes sense to think about some scale separation. In Jetscape, scale separation is realized very explicitly. Now, this is the picture that James was showing on Monday. And you can see that the top row is corresponding to jets, so corresponding to hard physics. And the bottom row is corresponding to the soft physics. So jets are logically separated from the soft bulk part. And in the end, everything is supposed to fit to hadronic cascade, which is not exactly true. Now, here on the next slide, you can see that there is a little to-do thing. Now, James was actually assuming that particles from jets are feeding to the last stage. It is not true yet. The only thing that gets into the hadronic cascade is particles from the hydrodynamics. So let's go and look at the codes first. This is also what James was showing, and there are different codes that work on the hard part, and there are different codes that work on the soft part. And you can see SMASH is on the very right. It is doing the hadronic rescattering. And we are going to be talking about the SMASH hadronic transport here. So, okay, now let's go once again and review specifically the soft part. This is the typical picture for the soft part of heavy ion collision simulation. There is some initial state for the hydrodynamics, and the hydrodynamics which Chun was really extensively discussing in his lecture. And then at some point, hadronization happens, and there was also a good question, what's the difference between hadronization and particleization at some point? So hadronization is when quarks turn into hadrons, and it can happen in the fluid phase. So, and particleization is when you turn fluid into particles. It can happen in the hadronic phase. So here, maybe even better term would be particleization. So fluid is turned into particles, and then SMASH takes over. This is the hadronic transport approach, which corresponds to the dilute phase of the collision. Why does it make sense to use both hydrodynamics and transport? It is not so easy. It means that you have to combine codes, but it also means that each code is applied in its region of applicability. Hydrodynamics needs local thermal equilibrium, and it needs that the mean free path is much smaller than system size. The fact that mean free path is